So in this lecture, we are going to compare DBMS with file system, or you can say we are going to see drawbacks of file system, or you can say we are going to see the advantages of DBMS. So you can write down the points, whatever points I will discuss in this lecture, in answer of three type of questions, right? In the previous video, I have already discussed the some fundamentals of DBMS, like what is data, what is information, what is database, what is DBMS, what is purpose of DBMS, means why we need DBMS, and some advantages and drawbacks we will discuss in this lecture. In the previous video, I have also discussed some applications of DBMS, right? So now first point is, first of all, what is file system? See, if you are using a computer, then you are definitely using a file system. File system comes with your operating system, and we don't even know that we are using that file system and how it works, but we are using file systems, right? It is what it is going to manage the file or the data we are going to store. See, in the system, how we are going to store the data? Maybe we have some drives, C, D or E drives, or there we have folders and we have subfolders, and there we are going to store our files, or some maybe notepad file, wordpad file, excel file, something like this, right? So this is what the management of this data is, what the role of file system only. We are going to store the data using file system only, right? DBMS is also used to manage the data, and file system is also used to manage the data. Now what is the difference between these two? See, here in file system, suppose I have created a file, a notepad file, it is having some value like 1, and there we have Jenny's lecture, and 2 after that I have written Jenny Lamba, means name of my second channel, right? Now how you are going to store this file into your hard drive, into your hard disk? Between hard disk and this file, we have first of all file system. This file, it is the responsibility of file system to save this file, to manage this file. So it is, you can say, interface type of thing between hard drive or your hard disk and you, right? So now we are using file system and we don't even know, right? If we don't use, if file system is not there in your operating system, then the complete data would be only one data at one place, and it is very difficult to manage that data, to search something or to access that data, right? It's because of the file system only we are able to partition our drives, we are able to create the folders, or you can say directories, subfolders and files, right? So that we can manage our data to somewhat, right? But we can manage the data, a short amount of data. When it comes to a large or huge amount of data, then file system is not a good idea to use. There we will use DBMS. Now suppose if you have installed a software or DBMS on your system, like maybe you can say MySQL or SQL Server, Oracle 9G or 10G, or you can say DB2, many types of DBMS softwares are available, right? Now suppose I have MySQL. Now here suppose I have created one table and there I have stored one. Now this is the table. Basically we are talking about RDBMS, that is Relational Database Management System. There we are going to store the data in the form of relations or tables, and every table is having relationship among them, right? Now I have created using some, how you are going to create it? Obviously, we will use what? SQL, that is Structured Query Language. We are going to write down the queries in SQL and to access this database, or to perform this some operations on the database, like insertion, deletion, manipulation, all type of operations, right? For that, we are going to use SQL language, Structured Query Language. Now, this table is also going to be stored in, obviously, hard disk. Now, there also we have file system. It's not like that we have removed this file system from here. Obviously, we have file system on our PC, right? But now for managing this data, for managing our database, we are using DBMS. And here for managing our database, we are using file system. It's not like that we have completely removed file system and we are using DBMS. That is a very important point. We still have file system, right? First of all, this, obviously we have DBMS, this is MySQL, right? There I'm going to create a table and that will go to file system, and that after that it will be stored in hard disk, right? But only difference is what? Here for managing the data, I'm using DBMS, but here for managing the data, simple file system is responsible. Right. Now, why we have switched from here to here? Why we are using DBMS for managing the data? Obviously, the file system cannot manage the data efficiently, right? If small amount of data is there, in the last video, I have taken an example that I have 10 friends and I want to store the phone number, age and address of only 10 friends. Then obviously, no need to install a DBMS. Only we can make a notepad file, there I can store name of 10 friends, their phone number, their age and their address, and I can store. If I want to access, then simply I can access that. If I want to search something, then obviously the data is very small, so I can easily search. So only by using the file system I can manage my data. But suppose you can say it's a hospital management system, there we have multiple tables. Tables for patients, for doctors, for registrations, or for other helping staff, for inventory as well. Many information we need to store. For all the information, obviously, we cannot make the tables, right? If we make the tables for this, like we have many tables. For hospital management system, we have 10 to 12 tables maybe, right, in our database. So only using file system can we manage all the tables. Obviously, that would be a very problematic situation. We cannot manage this table. That is why for managing this database, for a large database, we need DBMS, right? Now, what can be the problems here if we use file system for managing a large database? See, here the very first difference between this and this is what? Here the data is stored. See, directly this data is going to be stored in hard disk, right? Have we defined any data type here, that int data type or string or float or something like this? No. So as it is, the raw data is going to be stored in hard disk. That is, data here is unstructured data. Means here, unstructured data is what? The data which is not structured using some predefined data models or schemas, right? Here we don't define any data type or any constraint on the data, right? That is unstructured data. Unstructured data may be in the form of text, or it may be non-textual. It may be audio, it may be video, YouTube videos, or you can say unstructured data may be collected from social media, that is data from Facebook or data from Twitter or from LinkedIn, or maybe through that chat, WhatsApp data, or you can say that Instagram data. That is what unstructured data, right? We don't have any proper, you know, definition or predefined structure of that data, right? And now in today's world, 80% of data is unstructured data, right? But now in this case, see here, when you are going to create this table, then you will have to define the name of the table, the data type. Here we have integer, here we have maybe string, or maybe in another column you can say float, or the name of the columns and something like this. Now, if the data type is integer, then here you cannot store, suppose I'm going to store A here, then that will give error. So here the data is predefined. We are going to define the structure, we are going to structure the data in a proper way. So here we are dealing with structured data. This is the very first and basic difference between this and this. And obviously, if the data is structured in a proper way, then searching would be very easy on a structured data rather than unstructured data. And in today's world, we are dealing with unstructured data, means 80% of the data is unstructured data, right? So where it is going to be used? In data mining, right? How we will use this unstructured data in data mining? We will use some mining tools and we will extract some patterns. Like, for example, when you go for shopping in a mall, then you always noticed, I guess you have noticed, that in one shelf, if bread is there, then in the next of this bread, they are not going to put any shampoo, or they are not going to put any stationery items like this. Nearby this bread, they'll put either milk, or you can say cake, or something like this, right? So that's what they have the pattern, that if someone is going to buy a bread, then 80% of chances are there, hill, by, maybe, jam or milk, something like this. So these kind of things they will put together, right? So that's what where data mining comes into picture, and the unstructured data comes into picture. But that is a different subject, that is data mining and data warehousing. That I'm not going to discuss that thing in deep. Here we are discussing the difference between file system and DBMS. So here one problem may be because of this unstructured data is, see, different people means different format they are going to follow, or maybe if same person is using that data, means I am the user and I am creating the data on my laptop and I am using that data, I am responsible for managing that data, like user is responsible for managing that data, right? So now here suppose it in one file I have stored the date in this format, right? And at one file I have stored date something like this. So maybe format is, first of all I'll store month, then day, then year. And format may be, first of all I'll store day, then month, then year. There is no specific format defined, right? So that would create a confusion, right? Maybe here we have more than one table, means 5-10 tables. There I can store one, in one file I can store in this format, in another file I can store in this format, then that would be problematic situation, right? Now next point may be, see, if I want to access this file, I have stored this file somewhere, I want to access this file, obviously I can access the file here using any programming language. You can write down a C program, you can write program in C++ or Java, something like this, and you can access this file, right? But for this, the problem is you need to know the location of this file, in which drive, in which folder this file is stored. After that only you can access this file, right? So here you need to know the file location, right? So now it's fine if I am the only user and I am accessing the data on my laptop, so I know where the data is. But if more than one user is accessing the same data, means in nowadays we are using what, that client server architecture, right? Here something like this, the data is stored on the server here and many users are there, or you can say clients are there all over the world who are using this, who are accessing this database, right, which is on server. Now obviously I don't know where the data is, because data may be present at remote location. Fine, like this only, I don't know where my YouTube videos are stored, I don't know the location, you don't know the location. If you want to search something, you simply write down the name, means the topic name, and you will get the information. You don't need to know that where that data is present, in which server, the server which is in India or the server which is in USA, you don't even know, right? So that is the beauty of DBMS. You don't need to know the location of that data to access that data, right? So that is the second difference. Now here third point is what? See, suppose in my file I have multiple data and the size of file is around 20 GB. And here I want to access only small information, that is of 25 KB only, right? Only one row suppose I want to access. Now here obviously for accessing this you need to write a program in C language, suppose you are writing a program. So for that thing, when you write a C program, then you will access this complete file. This complete file would be transferred to you, right? But I don't want a data of 25 GB. I just want information of 25 KB only. So that is problem in file system, right? Now in DBMS only you can get this information. You will not get the complete file. You will get only this information, that is of 25 KB only, the information you want from that file, right? That is another advantage of that DBMS. Next point is, here in file system, how to access the data? We are going to write proper program, maybe in C language or any language, right? So suppose a bank is using file system, not using any DBMS, and there obviously we have multiple tables, and from here I want to access the information. My query is, I want to access the name of those account holders, those persons whose account is having a balance less than 1000, right? So there we cannot write down a query, there we have to write down a complete program, and obviously I can get this result. Now our second question is, I want to access the name of those persons whose account is having a balance greater than 1 lakh, right? Now for that you have to write down what? Another program, and you have to compile that program, and after that only you can get this result. So for each query you are supposed to write down a complete program. That is not a good idea. But here only you need to write down a simple query and you can get this result. After that again a simple query and you can get this result. No need to write down, no need to compile a complete program, right? So here in file system you can write, here file system allows only that predetermined access to the data, that is using some compiled programs, right? Here in DBMS, if you are using DBMS, then here the flexible access of the data is possible, right? Next point is data redundancy, means data duplicacy. Duplicate data is present in, may be present in file system, right? In the previous case also we have discussed in the previous video that suppose I have this table, I have 10 friends and the data I am storing is name, phone number, age and address. Now suppose I want to show this data, I want to share this file with another user, another friend of me, and I want to show the phone number, right? Then what can you do? You can create another file and from there you can delete phone number, and in that file we have this, this and this. So now we have two files, one is this one, one is another one which is not having phone number. Now to another person I want to show this file, but I don't want to show the age, or you can say I don't want to show the address. Then I can create another file F3, and there that file will contain these three columns and it is not containing address, I have deleted this. So now I have three files. Now this is what? Data redundancy, na? Data duplication. Now what is the use of storing the same data again and again? So that is the problem in file system. For making this file secure, because I am obviously creating these files for security purpose, I don't want to show phone number, I don't want to show address. But now the problem is data redundancy, that have created another problem, right? Or here you can take one example, like one faculty is taking subject in CSC and EC department, right? Here data structure, here suppose DBMS, and the faculty name is same, suppose you can say Jenny and Jenny. So all the details of Jenny would be same, but here we have two files, two locations in CSC department also, in EC department also, the same information is stored, right? Now this is what data redundancy. Fine, no need to store the same, the detail of same faculty at two place. So now because of this redundancy, another problem is inconsistency. Now what does this inconsistency means? Now suppose this faculty has left the college, right? So they have updated in this table, right, in CSC department, and they have deleted the profile, but this profile is still in EC department. So data is now inconsistent, right? It should be updated in both the tables, or in maybe all the tables. The changes should be reflected in all the tables. So manually it is very tough. If you have 10, 15, 20 tables and all the tables are having some information related to me, then from all the tables that information should be deleted. So that would be a tough job if you are not using DBMS. So now next is concurrent access. Suppose there is one file and many users are accessing this file. This is what concurrent access, right? So that would be problematic in file system. Why so? Because see, suppose two users are reading this file, then that is fine, there would be no problem. But if one is reading, one is writing, right? That is read write, or one is writing, another is reading, or one is writing, another is also writing, then that would create a problem, right? So here we should have some concurrency protocols, like some locking mechanisms. If one person is writing or updating this file, then other person cannot read that file. After completion of the writing, after completion of the updation, another person can read that file, right? That should be a case. Now in file system there is no concurrency protocols, but in DBMS we have concurrency protocols. That thing also we will discuss one by one in later videos. So concurrent access is a problem in file system. So now here you can also say we will not allow multiple users to access the file, Right, at one time only one can access that file, either read or write. But that is also not possible in nowadays, because see, suppose you are I'm taking an example of railways. Suppose at one time only one person can book the ticket, or only one person can access that site or something like this, no concurrent access to this railway database, then that would be obviously a problematic situation, because I guess in one day around 7 to 8 lakhs bookings are there on this railway, right? So concurrent access is must nowadays on database, right? You have to implement concurrent access, and for avoiding the problem you need some protocols, and those concurrency protocols are there in DBMS. They are not in file system. Next point may be integrity. See, on DBMS, on the data, I can add integrity constraints. Like what? Suppose in a banking system, I want to add a constraint like this: if your balance, your bank balance goes less than 1000, then automatically 25 rupees will be detected. Something like this. This kind of constraint I can apply on the data in DBMS, because in DBMS the data is predefined. When we are going to define the data, then only I can put the constraint. But here in file system, the unstructured data is there. We cannot, you know, define anything on that data, right? So integrity problem is also there in file system. Next issue is security. Security of data is less in this file system. Here in this example only you can show that security is not much in file system. Or you can say here we can put that read write permission on the folders and files, but we cannot put these kind of access permission on a portion of a file, on small portion of a file. We can put this on a complete file or folder, right? But in DBMS it is possible, right? The mechanism for security is much more, means for backup mechanisms, for recovery mechanism is also there in DBMS. That is not possible in a file system. If we want to backup the data, means backing of the data in file system is very tough. Why? So because data is unstructured, data is not predefined, but here backing of the data is easy. In this example only security is there. If you don't want to show the phone number, then simply you can write down a query. You can fetch name, age and address, and you can show another user. So that is, data is more secure in DBMS. It's not a case in file system. To making it more secure, either you have to create another file and from that file you can delete phone number, but in that case it will create a problem of data redundancy and as well as data inconsistency, right? So now here on the basis of these points I have compared file system and DBMS. There you can say, maybe you can write these are drawbacks of file system, or you can write these points as in advantages of DBMS, right? I'm not saying that these are the points, these are the only points for comparison of this file system and DBMS. You can compare these on many more points also. In next video, I'll discuss about functional dependencies, means what is functional dependencies, and after that we will start normalization. So now I'll see you in the next video. Till then, bye bye, take care.